Good morning, children. How are you? Hope you all fine. Today we are going to start one lesson from geography. It's your favorite subject, right? So children, the topic of our lesson is globe, latitudes and longitudes. Okay, children? So we are going to see about latitudes and longitudes. First, what is globe? Globe is a true model, that is miniature form of the earth. Okay, children? Globes may be of different size, different type. Okay, some will be very big, some will be very small. If it is very big, we cannot take that to everywhere, right? We cannot carry that. If it is small, we can take that to every place. Yes, children? Next. Then this globe is not fixed. It can be rotated. Okay, children? Like it can be rotated the same way as a top spin, like a ball we can rotate, or a potter wheel, that wheel also we can rotate. Okay, children? Then next, on the globe, we can locate countries, continents and oceans. Okay, what all we can locate? Countries, continents and oceans. They are all shown in their correct size. Next, as I told you, this globe is a miniature form of earth. So now we are going to see that. First, you look this picture. What is there? Some vessels. So for this vessel, we have some miniature form, right? We used to play that miniature set for playing kitchen set, right? So we'll see that. So this is a playing kitchen set, right? We used to play. Similarly, for the earth, the globe is the miniature form. Okay, children? So have you all understood? Okay. So next, globes. Globes are of varying size and varying types. Many types of globes are there. Okay. See, look at this picture. So this is pocket globe. We can take to any place. We can carry that everywhere. Okay, children? So next, this is balloon globe. So we can inflate and we can take to any place, that are also handy. Next, this globe you can find in some office and all. They used to keep it on the table, right? So this is the table globe. So like this, there are many types of globes. Okay, children? Some are big and some are very small. Okay, children? Next, globe. So see this globe, as I told you, you can spin the globe. You can spin that ball, or the wheel also you can rotate. Next, now we are going to see deeply about globe. First, the top and bottom of the earth are called poles. Okay, the top and bottom of the earth are called poles. Okay, they are similar. They are same at top and bottom of the globe are same. Okay, next, the top is called North Pole and the bottom is called South Pole. Okay, so how many poles we have? We have two poles. Okay, children, the top is called North Pole and the bottom pole is South Pole. So what are the two poles? North Pole and South Pole. Next, children. So next we are going to see about axis. So as I told you, this globe we can rotate, right? So it used to rotate around the pivots. It has one axis. Okay. So that axis is an imaginary line. Okay. This earth rotates around an imaginary line. This imaginary line is called axis of the earth. So here you can see one red line, right? So this red line is called axis. So it is an imaginary line. Imaginary line means that does not exist really. It's an imaginary line. Okay. Okay, next. So the next one is equator. Okay, next we are going to see about equator. The imaginary line, this is also imaginary line that is running on the globe, that divides the globe into two equal halves. Okay, children, it divides the globe into two equal halves. Look here, the red line. So this is equator. This is called equator. This is an imaginary line that running on the globe that divides the earth into two equal halves. Okay, children. So where is the equator? This is the equator. So this line is called equator. Next, the northern half of the earth, the northern half, the top half is called as northern hemisphere. The southern half, the down part, is called as southern hemisphere. Okay, the north half is known as northern hemisphere and the south half is called as southern hemisphere. Understood, children? Next, parallels of latitudes. So like this equator, there are some parallel circles. Okay, from equator to the holes, there are some parallels of latitudes. These latitudes are measured in degrees. Okay, children. So some important parallels of latitudes are there that we are going to see now. First, Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer. Second, Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn. Third, Arctic Circle. Third, Arctic Circle. Fourth, Antarctic Circle. Fourth, Antarctic Circle. So first, what is the first one? Tropic of Cancer. So degree of that is 23 and a half degrees north. 23 and a half degrees north. Okay, so Tropic of Cancer is in the northern hemisphere. Tropic of Cancer is in the northern hemisphere. Then next, second one, Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn. Okay. Degree is 23 and a half degrees south. Degree is 23 and a half degrees south. Okay, that is in southern hemisphere. Okay, children. The next, third one. Third one is Arctic Circle. That is as 66 and a half degrees north of the equator. 66 and a half degrees north. Okay. Then last one is Antarctic Circle. Degree is 66 and a half degrees south. Understood, children? Next. So look this picture, we can understand that very clearly. So first, what is the center line? Center line is equator. Okay, center line is equator, that is dividing the globe into two equal halves. Okay, so 0 degree, equator is 0 degree. Okay, children, the next, Tropic of Cancer. This Tropic of Cancer is at 23 and a half degrees north. Okay, it is north of equator. Okay, next, what is the second one? Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn is in 23 and a half degrees south. Okay, children, next, Arctic Circle. Arctic Circle is at 66.5 or 66 and a half degrees north. Okay, children, next, Antarctic Circle. Antarctic Circle is at 66.5 or 66 and a half degrees south. Next, North Pole. North Pole is at 90 degrees north. South Pole is at 90 degrees. Yes. So understood? So first, equator. Equator is at 0 degree. Then Tropic of Cancer, that is 23 and a half degrees north. Tropic of Cancer, 23 and a half degrees south. Next, Arctic Circle, that is 66 and a half degrees north. Antarctic Circle, that is 66.5 or 66 and a half degrees south. Then North Pole, 90 degrees north, and South Pole, 90 degrees south. So you understood, children? Very good. Now we are going to see about heat zones. Okay, children. So first we see here, then I will explain detailing. So first, the place between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. This place, between this place, is called Torrid Zone. What zone, ma? Torrid Zone. Okay. Then next, the place between Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer, that is called Temperate Zone. Okay. So this is at north, right? So it is called North Temperate Zone. Okay, children. Then next, the place between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. So that place is called Temperate Zone. Since it is at the south, it is called South Temperate Zone. Okay, children. Then last, this place between Arctic Circle and North Pole is called Frigid Zone. And the place between South Pole and Antarctic Circle is called Frigid Zone. Understood, children? So now we are going to see this deeply. Okay, children? Next. So heat zones of the earth. First, we are going to see about Torrid Zone. So where is this Torrid Zone? This Torrid Zone is between Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So this place is called Torrid Zone. So look here, this pink, the arrow mark is showing, right? So this place is, this pink color place is called Torrid Zone. So this place, the midday sun is exactly overhead at least once a year, you know, on all latitudes between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So this area receives maximum heat. Okay, so this Torrid Zone receives maximum heat. Understood, children? Next, temperate zones. So as I told you two temperate zones, right? North temperate zone and south temperate zone. So this yellow color arrow mark is showing, right? North and south temperate zone. Here the midday sun is never overhead. Okay, so here this area have mild temperature. Okay, not all that heat, not all that cold, mild temperature. These zones are called temperate zones. Understood, children? Next, frigid zones. So where are frigid zones? It's here, blue color, it's arrow mark, it's given, right? North frigid zone and south frigid zone. Areas between Arctic Circle and North Pole is called North Frigid Zone, and the areas between Antarctic Circle and South Pole is called South Frigid Zone. Understood, children? So here what happens means, due to the sun is never much above the horizon. The sun is never much. So here they have very least amount of heat and remains very cold. Here the temperature is very, very, very cold. Okay. So these zones are called frigid zones. So these zones are called frigid zones. Okay, children. So how many zones we have seen? Torrid zone. And next we have seen about temperate zones. And last about frigid zones. So are you all clear about this, children? Okay, children. So we are. That's all for today's class. So thank you, children. So thank you for listening very patiently. I hope you all understood this topic. So we have covered latitudes, and remaining of this chapter we will see in the next video. So until that, you read the chapter till where I have taken, you read clearly, and remaining I will take in the next class. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.